Kate Bush en haar cloudbusting. Wat mij betreft een van de allermooiste liedjes ooit gemaakt. Zal altijd, echt voor altijd bij me blijven. Ik zei net nog van, dan weet je tenminste wat je moet draaien op mijn uitvaart. Michiel zegt, ik word er een beetje weemoedig van. Ik ga nog lang niet hoor, maar dan weet je dat tenminste. Prachtig liedje. En ik heb Rosbro hier te gast. Misschien heb je net gehoord hoe die Burn Blue deed. And the first thing you said about Kate Bush was, oh, great tune.
Yeah, I love that song. And I love the video as well. The video seems like one of those movies that you've never got to see, but you know you would love with all your heart, like with Donald Sutherland and stuff running around. And it's amazing.
Yeah, it is. It's absolutely great. By the way, this interview is derailing already, because I saw on your Instagram that you draw a lot of actors, but you never drew Kiefer Sutherland, did you?
No, not yet. But I'm a huge Lost Boys is my favorite movie of all time. I have a huge poster of it in my living room and everything. Like, so maybe that might be next when I get home. It takes a long time to do those big portraits. Like, so maybe when I'm home I'll plan to do one.
Yeah, I understand you're very very busy. You just came off stage in Tivoli Vredenburg where you opened for Amy McDonald. How was that?
Yeah, it was amazing. It was such a big room and everyone was so, so friendly. And we literally just were able to pack everything up and then we just hopped in a car and drove here at the appropriate speed. So we did.
Nothing appropriate here. Nothing inappropriate to see. I read somewhere that you said that music is sort of your religion.
Yeah. When I was growing up, there was nothing really in my house apart from music. Rock stars and things were just a normal thing on TV. Music was just part of life and it sort of just fell into that. I'm not really a religious person in any other sense, but I think you can't deny the connection that you get from people. And it's sound waves. And sound waves and pushes of air can make you cry, which is probably the most religious experience that I've ever had. And I know every single person that I know has had the exact same experience. So I think there's some sort of unity in that. And that's just beautiful.
Yeah, I actually used the words that a song I played tonight resonates with parts of my sadness.
Yeah.
So that's actually the same thing.
Yeah, it's amazing. Song can just go in there and pluck a memory from the back of your head that you never even knew existed anymore and just bring it out in front of you. And I think that's a wonderful thing.
Another thing I saw on your Instagram is that you have the most extraordinary like tap-tap delay guitar pedals.
Yes.
With Bob Ross.
Bob Ross is king. If music's religion, then Bob Ross is definitely Jesus. So he is. He's the man. I have spent many an hour wasted staring at Netflix watching Bob Ross. And I've tried a couple of patents too. And they're not too bad with Bob Ross's instruction. I got there like happy little trees everywhere.
A little bit of Van Dyke Brown.
Yeah.
Maybe you should explain to our listeners who Bob Ross is. I don't know if everybody knows because he's been gone for a while.
Yeah. Bob Ross was like, I think it was in the 80s. He was on American Public TV and he would instruct you how to make an oil painting within 20 minutes. But he has the most amazing afro. The most beautiful open shirt that's just opened two buttons too much. But when he talks, he's got the most soothing voice ever. He's just like, he's almost like Buddha incarnate with a paintbrush. And he talks you through these beautiful scenes, but he can't paint shacks. When he paints a shack or a barn, it looks like something really bad's about to happen in it.
Looks like a squirrel.
Yeah. Oh, he loves squirrels too. He gets some of these animals that he finds in his home and stuff and brings them out. And it's the cutest, most wonderful, wholesome TV you'll ever watch. So I can't recommend it enough. And that's why I have him on my pedal board. Because every time when I look down at a gig, I see Bob Ross staring back at me.
And you just get completely zen.
Yeah.
And chilled out.
Yeah, completely. All these triangles.
I'd say, do you have the tap-tap delay pedal?
I haven't brought it with me. No, we had to leave Bob at the venue, so we did. But we'll be reunited quite soon.